My name is Jennifer Alix-Garcia, and I am a professor and head of the Department of Applied Economics at Oregon State University. I study a program of payments for ecosystem services. These kinds of programs are sometimes called PES programs, and the one that I study is located in Mexico. So the idea of a PES program is that you pay somebody to do something environmentally friendly. So in the case of Mexico, people are paid to conserve forest. And it's not just that they're being paid for the forest, they're also being paid for the services that that forest provides, like carbon sequestration, biodiversity conservation, natural beauty. We find that the Payments for Ecosystem Services program in Mexico reduces deforestation and supports people's livelihoods. And it's most effective where the forest is at highest threat. So if producers had the intention of actually cutting the forest down, then this program could have a big impact. In order to assess whether or not PES prevents deforestation, we use data that is based on satellite imagery. So that we measure the vegetative cover using satellites and translating that into measures of forest. And then we compare the land that's enrolled in the program with land that applied to the program but wasn't accepted. So you have a sort of treatment and control group. And by making the comparison between those two, we can measure whether or not the program actually prevented deforestation. Land use change accounts for about 11% of global carbon emissions. And preventing land use change or deforestation is one of the lowest cost ways that we have to address climate change. It's cheaper than changing polluting technology. It's cheaper than reforestation. It's basically should be the first thing that we do. Besides being low cost, it's nice to preserve forests for other reasons. So forests provide carbon sequestration, and that's a great thing. But they also provide other services, like conserving biodiversity so we can extract future technologies, and preventing erosion and landslides that are a big risk in a lot of places. This program also fits in well to my larger goal, which is to look at environmental policies that help conserve the environment while also preserving people's livelihoods. I think this is probably the most pressing issue that we face in the world, how to reconcile economic growth with environmental conservation. And it's something that we should all be concerned about. It's why I do all my work. I think that climate change can be a discouraging issue to think about because it's so big. Individual changes can help combat climate change. Things like walking to work and composting your food can have an impact. But the most important thing that people can do is to vote for politicians who are willing to put in place policies to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Without big policy changes, we can't really address the problem.